the kings who are gone. Jenny would dance with her ghost, the ones she had lost and the ones she had found, and the ones who had loved her the most, the ones who'd been gone for so very long, couldn't remember the name. They spun her around on the damp cold stone, spun away all her sorrow and pain. Of the kings who are gone, Jenny would dance with her ghost, the ones she had lost and the ones she had found, and the ones who had loved her the most, the ones who'd been gone for so very long, she couldn't remember the names. They spun her around on the damp old stone, spun away all her sorrow and pain, and she never wanted to leave, never wanted to leave, never wanted to leave, never wanted to leave, never. Never, never wanted to leave.
asleep. The difference is that when the brain is awake, there is a material frame that makes us perceive things in a linear way. When we go to sleep, we do not have the frame, and the dream has the tendency to change constantly. Humans are dreaming all the time. Before we were born, the humans before us created a big outside dream that we will call society's dream, or the dream of the planet. The dream of the planet is the collective dream of billions of smaller personal dreams, which together create a dream of a family, a dream of a community, a dream of a city, a dream of a country, and finally, a dream of the whole humanity. The dream of the planet includes all of society's rules, its beliefs, its laws, its religions, its different cultures and ways to be, its governments, schools, social events, and holidays. We are born with the capacity to learn how to dream. And the humans who lived before us teach us how to dream the way society dreams. The outside dream has so many rules that when a new human is born, we hook the child's attention and introduce these rules into his or her mind. The outside dream uses mom and dad, the schools and religion to teach us how to dream. Attention is the ability we have to discriminate and to focus only on that which we want to perceive. We can perceive millions of things simultaneously, but using our attention, we can hold whatever we want to perceive in the foreground of our mind.
Information is by